Hello students, changes physical and chemical. Under this lesson we seen the different types of changes: natural, artificial, man-made, useful change, harmful change, periodic change and non-periodic change, fast change, slow change, then afterwards reversible and irreversible change, and periodic and non-periodic change. After that we seen the next term, that is physical change and the chemical change too yesterday. Now let's recall inside, we will see the next part of our lesson. So here it is, what process occur during the change of state of matter, what is happening actually. So when the changes takes place, there are some bonds are there in between the substances break and some new bonds are formed. Okay, when it is a chemical change and physical change inside, the conditions are changing because of the atmospheric condition, that is temperature and all. What happens when water is taken in bowl and heated? What will happen when we heat it? It turns into the water vapors. And the process of formation of vapor, from a liquid is called as a evaporation. And that we had studied from lower classes, that is what is the process of evaporation. In the process of evaporation, when we provide heat to a substance, its state changes. And that is called as a evaporation. So inside it, drying of clothes. Inside it also what happens, water which are present, which is present in the wet clothes, it transform into the water vapors. Next is the formation of salt. When salt form, the water evaporates and the which, that is the substance, the sodium chloride left behind in the process of evaporation from the seawater are possible due to the evaporation. These processes are possible because of only, that is the evaporation. We have studied some processes that are a part of our, part of the water cycle. Okay, so which are those? As we know that water from the lake, otherwise water from the sea, evaporates due to the temperature. When it evaporates water, it moves, goes upside, and when it gets a cool air, it condenses, it forms a cloud, and when it gets a cool air, that clouds becomes cool, and water from that cloud, what happens, it becomes what, condenses, means it transfer, water vapors transform into water drops, and what happens, that water falls on the ground in the form of a rain drops, and that is the water cycle. And that water again seeps into the ground, again it gets collected, it is stored, and again it evaporates. Again it call clouds form, clouds cool, and then what happens, the rain is falling. Which are these processes? Do the original properties of water change during this, those processes? In this process inside, the properties of water are changes? No. Water's color means physical properties inside. If we are thinking, when the water turns into the vapors, the constituents of water are H2O, hydrogen and oxygen. It remains as it is. Its taste is not changes, its color is not changed, only the state it changing. Okay, so here what I told you, we have studied some processes that are the part of water cycle. And which are these processes? Do the original properties of water change? No, the original properties of water is water are not changing. Previously, we have learned about the process of one, dissolving, boiling, melting. They are all examples of physical change. Dissolving, salt, what happens when we add to the water, the sugar solution forms. When water evaporates, sugar remains as it is, and the water vapors we can turn into the water again. Next point is the boiling. When we boil the water transform into the water vapors, but the water H2O remains in the constituent of water, that is H2O, is same in it. Next, melting. When ice, we provide heat to it, it melts, but it's a state changes, but its properties are not changing, and then these are called as a, they are examples of the physical change. Now, which of the following are physical changes and which are chemical, that we have to discuss. Making a table from wood, just tell me, is it physical or is it chemical change? What I told you, the physical change means original substance remains as it is. So here in this example, making a table from wood means when you are making the from wood, you are making table, you are making the stool, you are making any kind of furniture like bed, sofa set. Under this, what happens? The original substance, that is the wood, it remains as it is, and that's why it is a physical change. Okay. Now next example is the burning of wood. Now, for chemical change, what I told you, the original substance does not remain as it is. Its properties are changes. So, once wood burn, it forms coal, and when it again means provide heat to it, then it gives the ash. From ash, we are getting wood again. Is the ash shows any properties of wood? No. So, this is a chemical change. Next is the breaking of glass object. Suppose this is your glass. Okay, glass means glass object. It may be the mug, it may be the glass, or it may be the cup which is made up of the glass. When it breaks, what happens? Its pieces are formed. Its pieces are formed. But the original substance, it is made up of from the glass, the original substance is not changing. And that's why the breaking of glass object is a which type of change? That is a physical change. Next is the ripening of tomato. When if you see the tomato, the raw tomato, its color is green. When the tomato ripes, its color is red. The tomato which is green in color, its taste is different, and the ripening tomato is that its taste is different. Means original substance, what happens, undergo changes and it forms the new substance. Means the raw mango goes under the process of ripening and it forms the ripened mango and the tomato, and that's why this is the example of the chemical change. Next is the rusting of iron. When iron comes in contact with the oxygen which is present in the air or the water inside, what happens? It reacts with the iron and iron oxide is formed, ferrous oxide is formed. Okay, and in this process the original substance we are not getting back again, and that's why it is a chemical change. Clear all of you? Okay. Now the next point is the try this, means it is the experiment actually. We have to take evaporating dish, sugar, burner and the tripod stand. Now you can do this activity at home also. It's very easy. You have to take a spoon, in that spoon take some sugar and you provide heat to it. Okay, after some time what happens, the sugar gets melt and a liquid forms. Again if you provide heat to it, what happens, after some time all the water from the sugar evaporates, and what it forms, it forms a black color substance. Okay, that only activity is given here. We first of all see here, take some sugar in a evaporating dish, place the dish on a tripod stand and heat it. In a spoon also if you do the same activity, no problem. First of all put some sugar particles in it and then provide heat to it. When you provide heat to it, what happens, it start melting and first of all it forms a juice. And that juice, again if you are providing heat to it, that juice is there, it converts into a black substance, I told you before only. So observe the changes takes place in the sugar. Stop heating when the blackish substance is seen. Okay, at the bottom of the evaporating dish, what kind of change does above process bring about? Then when we provide heat to the sugar, the sugar starts melting, and again if we provide heat to it, then what happens, all the water vapors, water evaporates and a coal forms. And from that coal, we are not getting the original, it not shows the properties. What is the coal's formula? C. And what is the formula for the sugar? C12H22O. O11 means all the water evaporates in the process, in this process, and only carbon left behind it, and that's why the original substance, what happens, we are not getting back again, and that's why this process is called as a chemical change. Okay, till that clear all of you? Now we see the next part, what is given here. So this process is called as a chemical, this is a chemical change. Now next it is the corrosion. You know that process of corrosion. When iron articles rust, a reddish brown layer forms. A reddish brown layer forms on it. We seen that so many times. If you see now also, if any iron article is there nearby you and it remains open for some time, it may be the window grills color left, color gone from that place, then what happens? There that brown color substance is seen, and that is nothing but it is a iron, means ferrous oxide. A greenish layer is seen on the copper article. You have the copper basic vessels at home, means it may be the water container, or it may be the glass, it may be the what, the gods that statues are there, it is also made up of copper material. So green color layer is formed on that, on the copper article, and this process is called as a corrosion of metals. Means iron go rusting and it forms the iron oxide, and the copper goes rusting and it forms the copper copper oxide, and this process, copper oxide and copper sulfate, then this process is called as a corrosion of metals. Things become weak due to the corrosion. Okay, so because of corrosion, what happens? Things are becoming weak, means its a quality becomes deteriorates. Corrosion is caused by oxygen because of moisture and vapors of some chemicals like sulfur gas and all. Because of it also, what happens? The corrosion of metals takes place. Now here, do you know, iron articles are given a thin coat of zinc. Iron articles may be given the thin coat of zinc to prevent corrosion. Means suppose this is the iron article, okay, and we give the thin coat of the which thin coat to it, then what happens? It's a that iron get hide under the layer of zinc, and the contact of the iron and the air is what happens, get stopped, and due to this what happens, we can stop the corrosion, and this process is called as a galvanization. So what they told you, the iron articles are given a thin coat of zinc to prevent the corrosion, and this is called as a galvanization. Copper and brass articles are coated with the tin. Copper articles are also, and brass article, brass means in your home that pithal we are saying that having in our home, so that articles are coated with the tin layer, and due to this, and to avoid corrosion of the copper and the tin, copper and the brass, and this process is called as a tinning. We are using the tin, that's why this process is called as a tinning. Now, in this age of technology, a new process called as a powder coating has been developed. Powder coating is developed. Coats of various colors are applied on the metals, like iron, aluminium. You see, the non-stick wares have the different colors, red are there, blacks are there. So these processes are this is called as a powder coating. They prevent corrosion of metals. The metals are not get corroded because of this corrosion. While classifying changes, so always that is about this, do you know? Now always remember. Here, while classifying changes, we take into account only one criteria at a time. One criteria we use at one time. However, number of different criteria can be applied to the same change. Okay, for example, if I will take example of the, we will take the rusting of iron. Okay, so rusting of iron is natural process. Secondly, rusting of iron is a slow change because it takes more time. Rusting of iron is chemical change. because original substance we are not getting back again. So here one criteria, instead of one, more than one criteria also we can apply for the same. Ripening of fruit, we will take example. It is a natural change, it is slow change, it is chemical change. Again, it is non-periodic change. Once it ripen, then process completed. So in this way, we can use the more than one criteria for that changes of to understand the change. Okay, so that is about the lesson. And today we are going to stop here only, because we have finished our lesson. All of you complete the exercise, and the next lesson we will start. Then start on our next lecture. So today we are going to stop only. Okay, thank you and have a good day. Complete the exercise. Okay.